Hey everyone. Well, today we're tonight, whatever you want to call it. It's pretty dark out. Talk about clutch shoes. I've got a video on taking it apart and cleaning the pins and all that stuff. Well, I went out and ordered clutch shoes for my bike. So I went to Honda first, and they told me that it was on back order and there was no time frame that it might be off back order and they probably wouldn't have any. So I couldn't go Honda OEM, and I got looking online and looking at eBay and whatnot, and I was finding from like 80, 90 bucks, and I'm on a budget. So I found a set for 59 bucks. It was from Chinese Parts for Scooters. So I know I'm not endorsing Chinese products at all, by any means, but I need a new clutch to try to get rid of this damn chatter. And all the clutches that I've got are used, and they're just worn out, I think. So I purchased it, and it came in. So I'm going to show you. There's a couple of things also I want to touch base with. There, when I was doing my video on the rear cover, and I put RTV on it. Yes, there is a gasket that you can go to Honda and buy. It's about 40 bucks for the gasket for the cover, and you won't have to do the silicone trick like I did. Well, I got accused of being a hack, so I want to address that. I'm definitely not a hack, and I am doing the cheaper way out. If money was no object, I would go to Honda and I would get a gasket for my cover. But a $7 tube of RTV is a lot cheaper than $40 gasket. So that's why I went with the RTV. If you think I'm a hack and all that, well, you can, I guess, not watch my videos and unsubscribe. I really hope that doesn't happen, but I'm just trying to find ways that we can keep our helix going without having to spend an arm and a leg. So I'm going to be the guinea pig on this Chinese clutch. I will show you how I take it apart and put it together, which I've done before, but we'll do it again. And I want to show you there's two different kinds of clutches, and I'll go over that in a second here. So here we go. Let's get some business here. Okay, so there's two different clutches that I've found when I was looking online: a short pad and a long pad. Okay, this one's short. This is the one I got. It's long. The one I have on here from another old clutch is long. But as you can see from the wear pattern, this thing is just, it's uneven, and I don't know how old it is. It's rusty. I understand that. I understand the rust. Don't hate on me. But this is the one that I had in it before with the short pads. And it chattered, fucking shaked, sorry the language, shaked just as bad or worse than the long pad, because I flipped them back and forth. Bing, ba boom, ba bang. So when I tried to or went online and looked, I found long pad, and that was the cheap one, and I found some short pad ones. Well, in my opinion or thought process, is a longer surface area equals better grip. So I do believe this is going to have better grip. It is a Chinese product. I'm sorry for all you haters out there. Hate on me. I saved about $45 by going this route. I may end up crashing and killed, but you know, hey, it's worth $40 in my opinion. So what we're going to do is we're going to take the nut off. Boom. This is a 1 5/8 socket. And of course I had to adapt it down to a 1/2 inch because it's 3/4 inch. So, and once again, you have to stand on it and do all that stuff. So let me get you set up and we'll go from there. I think you can see, right? Yeah, basically. That might give you a little bit better light what I'm doing. So, basically, you gotta stand on this deal and take the nut off. Alright, pops up. There you have it. There's your clutch assembly. Yeah. It's getting thin too. It's getting pretty thin. So. Alright, we'll see. First, I'm going to push this down on here to make sure, because it's slotted. Okay, and you got, I think you can figure it out. All right. If you're this far in, you better know what you're doing. Okay, it fits on there. So that's a good thing. All right, this is the tricky part. Have your nut in your hand. Okay. See, it's kind of tricky when you're all by yourself. If I had someone here, I could just squeeze it together with my hand and have someone else. But you gotta make sure this nut threads on here right. Alright, this is what sucks about putting this together. I'm telling you. You Yes, they make a tool for this. Oh, yes. They sure do. I don't have it. It's not going. Oh, there it goes. All right. Made sure and went several threads by hand because you don't want to cross thread this. Turn up my hand. All right, so now I can tighten this down. Son of a bitch, huh? One more. All right, that's that. New clutch is installed. I'm gonna clean this part with some sandpaper and scuff it up real good, and then put it together, and I'll see what happens. So there you have it. I will do another video when I get it on there and test drive the vehicle. When I test drive the bike, I'll try to make a video of me driving it. And you can see how it goes. So I appreciate you guys watching. And please subscribe. I need subscribers. So if you love your Helix, watch videos. Keep it going. Do some maintenance. All right. Appreciate y'all. Peace out.